Hello students, I am Professor Khushbu Kais, Assistant Professor from Sri Sitaram Bhai Dananji Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Pune, Badami. Today we are going to discuss a topic, General and Technical Communication, from the subject Effective Technical Communication. So let's start. Let's define what is general communication. So messages that are non-technical or informal in nature are called general communication. So in simple language, general communication means the participants not only exchange information, news, ideas and feelings, but also create a shared views about any general topic they are communicating. For example, when your alarm clock goes off, it is communication through sound and urges you to get out of bed. So this is called general communication, where sound of an alarm clock urges you to get out of the bed. You use a particular brand of toothpaste by seeing an advertisement of that particular company is also a general communication. So general communication contains a general message. Let us discuss characteristics of general communication. Number one is, it is informal in style. It doesn't require any formality or technicality in general communication. Number two, no set pattern of communication is required. You do not require any kind of set pattern of communication. The name itself suggesting you that it is general in nature. Number two, it is mostly oral. General communication takes place mostly oral. Next characteristics is, it not always for a specific purpose. You do not require any kind of purpose for making or doing any general communication. Number next characteristics is, it doesn't involve the use of technical vocabulary or graphics. Now let's discuss what is technical communication. The message pertaining to technical, industrial or business matters are called technical communication. So technical communication defines the field as any form of communication that focuses on technical or specialized topics, communicates specifically by using technology or provides instruction on how to do something. So that message comes under technical communication. So for example, you communicate with your boss about the problems in your organization. That is a part of your technical communication. So technical communication contains a technical message. Now let us discuss what are the characteristics of technical communication. Number one, mostly formal. So technical communication always focusing on formal. It mostly formal. Number two, it also required certain set of pattern for communication. It follows a set of pattern. Number three, it can be both. It can be oral or it can be written also. So both can be used in technical communication. Another characteristic is, it always have a specific purpose and it is always for a specific audience. So it also involves this. The next technical communications characteristics is, it frequently involves technical words, jargons, graphics, etc. Now let's discuss importance of communication. As we all know that communication is very useful in Effective communication is very useful in professional life. So as we all know that communication is a very common phenomenon. As we all are social animals, we cannot live without communicating. So communication implies a two-way process. So let us discuss importance of communication. Number one, without communication, there can be no direction and control. So we can say over here that communication is acting as unifying link and binding and direction force in organization. So with the help of proper communication, you can give direction and control over the activities of your employees. Number two, communication is important for the creation of warm and friendly working environment. So if you are providing friendly, if you wanted to provide friendly and warm environment for your employees, you do have to communicate them frequently. So it also improves the relations of member of a group and employees in the organization. It also help out for the passing on and off of orders. It also help out for making the policies and plans to your subordinates. And also, it also involves levels of information that need to be transferred to your employees. Another important is, without communication, there would not be any basis for answering your questions. Most important, without communication, you cannot answer to the question which is arise at your workplace. So it also help out for solving a problem, obtaining any feedback and measurement of a result. So communication plays a very significant role in the process of any needed change that need to be done by your organization. Next is, communication helps to improve support for change. As we all know that change is not easily acceptable by people. People do resist of a change. But with the help of effective communication, you can also making your people accept the needed change of the organization. So communication keeps the wheels of an organization running smoothly. So these are the importance of communication. Now we are going to discuss noise. Every communication channel have a noise. So let us discuss what is noise. A physical sound or a mental disturbance that disrupt the flow of communication as the sender or receiver get distracted by it is called noise. So simply a sound, a physical sound or mental disturbance that hinders our communication flow is called as noise. So any unplanned interferences in communication environment which causes hindrance in our transmission of message, that is also called noise. So noise means simple word that is making our communication hindrance. It is making distraction. So it can be a physical sound or mental disturbance that disturbing our flow of communication. If we are a sender or receiver, we are distracted by it is called as noise. Now we are going to discuss the types of noise. There are two types of noise that we are going to discuss. Number one is physical noise and number two is psychological noise. So let us understand first what is physical noise. It is the sound which given by surrounding and hamper our listening process. So for example, while speaking on the telephone, there may be a disturbances or queer squeaking noise or squeaking sound that disturbs your communication flow. That also involves in physical sound. So this disturbances can be done away by companies by having a soundproof room for discussion. So physical noise are surrounded by people and it hampers our listening process. It is called as physical noise. Now, number two, psychological noise. This is the effect of the noise which result in welcome ideas or thoughts crowding the mind which are of more relevant than the ensuring communication to either of the participants. So simply, psychological noise means what? A mental disturbance, or while we are listening to someone, unwelcoming ideas, thoughts coming in your mind, that is psychological noise, which is hampering your communication flow or communication channel, that is called as psychological noise. for example, mental turbulence, preoccupations, ego hangups, anxiety, tiredness, preconceived ideas and notions are making our communication flow break by psychological noise. So these are the types of noise. Now we are going to discuss what is verbal and non-verbal communication. With the help of word that we are doing communication is called as verbal communication, and without help of word is called as non-verbal communication. So communication is a two-way process. It takes place between one and one. Like if you are making conversation with you and your friend, so that is a conversation kind of communication, or we can say one-on-one conversation. Number two is many-to-one. Like interview panels are sitting over there and taking interview of one individual. So that is many-to-one kind of communication. One-to-many, when professors or teachers are teaching so many students, that is a part of one-to-many communication. Many-to-many, for example, group discussions are taking place and the students or the people who is participating in group discussions are discussing. So that is many-to-many. So communication can happen in various ways. It can be a verbal and non-verbal. So verbal communication can be a oral or written. And non-verbal communication can be your facial expression, your body language, gesture, posture, eye contact, your tone are part of your non-verbal communication. Now, let's discuss what is verbal communication. When messages or information is exchange of communicated through words is called verbal communication. So with the help of word, whatever the information or whatever the thoughts we are exchanging with other people is called as verbal communication. So verbal communication can be of a two type. It can be a oral or it can be a written. So verbal communication takes place through face-to-face conversations, group discussions, counseling, interview, radio, television, calls, memos, letters, report, notes, email, etc. So these are the part of verbal communication. Now let us discuss what is non-verbal communication. When messages or information is exchanged without using any kind of spoken word or written word is known as non-verbal communication. So non-verbal communication is usually understood as the process of communication through sending and receiving wordless message, where no single verbal words is used in communication, but you are using your body language as a part of communication. So non-verbal communication takes place through gesture, facial expressions, eye contact, physical proximity, touching, etc. Now, let's see functions of non-verbal communications. Number one is to express emotions. You can express your emotions through non-verbal communication, like if you are happy, if you are sad, if you are angry, you can share your emotions through that with your facial expression. You can also express your interpersonal attitudes through non-verbal communication. Next is to facilitate special tasks. Next function is to provide information consciously or unconsciously. Like sometimes you do not know that which body language or sign that are using consciously or unconsciously, but it provides information through that. Next is to control or influence others. As we all know that our body language plays a very important role for sending our message to ultimate receiver. So it also control or influence others. Next is to self-representations of one's personality. So the way we are responding to the non-verbal sign and symbol, it also represents our personality. Another one is to perform rituals. Next is to qualify, competent, contradict or expand verbal messages. So your non-verbal signing symbol should be matching with your verbal words. If it is not so, it is creating confusion in the mind of people. Now, we are going to discuss importance of non-verbal communication. So, non-verbal communication playing very important role for people to learn whether you are painful or joyful. From their day-to-day living, it creates more impact than verbal communication. So, as we all know that non-verbal communication plays more impact compared to verbal communication. Next importance is non-verbal cues are especially important in conveying feelings. Like if you are happy, so your voice, your expressions are also shown on your face. So this is considered as reliable. People can deceive others more easily with words than they can with their bodies. Another important is words are relatively easy to control. We can control our words, but facial expressions, body language, and vocal characteristics are hard to control. So by paying careful attention to non-verbal cues, people can detect deceptions or affirm honesty in an individual's message. Next importance is people have more faith in non-verbal cues than they have in verbal messages. So if an individual says one thing but transmits a conflicting message non-verbally, people almost invariably believe the non-verbal signals. So as we already discussed that non-verbal sign and symbols are very difficult to control. It is inherently shown by an individual, but you can control your verbal words. So people will definitely believe your non-verbal sign and symbol because it have the more impact compared to verbal words. So now let's define how we can differentiate a verbal and non-verbal communication. Number one, non-verbal communication is less structured. It doesn't require any structure, which makes it more difficult to study. Everybody's facial expressions, everybody's body language is different. So it is difficult for someone to understand. No one teaches a baby to cry or to smile, yet this form of self-expressions are almost universal. So other type of non-verbal communication such as meaning of colors and certain gesture, it is vary from one culture to another culture. As we all know that every culture do have their own beliefs, own values. So they are also using their sign and symbol differently. Another one is non-verbal communication also differs from verbal communication in terms of instant and spontaneity. So non-verbal communication has a few rules and often occurs unconsciously. So non-verbal communication signals are usually sent involuntarily and received subconsciously. So non-verbal communication are so spontaneous compared to verbal communication. So when a girl blushes, it comes naturally without her concern. Her emotions are written all over her face. So this is all for today's session. I hope you have understood it. Thank you all for listening. Thank you very much.